What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video we're talking about lines in Revit. So even though BIM means basically we're creating model elements, we still have to use lines sometimes. So I wanted to create a video where I go over a couple of tools in Revit that we have when it comes to creating lines. So what's the difference between these two tools and when to use each one of them, how to customize your lines, and also some tips and tricks to make you a bit more efficient when it comes to creating lines inside of Revit. Now, before we jump into the video, I would like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. There you can find all of my Revit courses where I cover numerous different topics at different skill levels. So if you're a beginner, intermediate level user, as well as an advanced level user, there is something there for everybody. For example, I have a whole course on advanced graphics inside of Revit. Now, in addition to the courses, you can find some of my customized ready-to-go Revit templates. You can also find some really high-quality Revit families. Recently, we have added some more families there to the offer, and then also there is a plugin that you can check out. Okay, so now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And as you can see, here I am in Revit. I'm just at the home screen. So let's start a new project by going here to Models and then go to New. Now, for the template file, I'm just going to be using my architecture design template, and then I'm just going to click OK. If you want to check out that template or my other templates, I'm going to link it up in the cards above. Anyways, now let's go here. Let's go to level 1. And I'm just going to get rid of the starting view for now, and let's get started. So when it comes to lines, you have a couple of options. The first one is here on the Architecture tab on the Model panel. We have Model Lines. Now, also on the Annotate tab, we also have the detail panel here, and then here we have the Detail Line. The Detail Line has the DL shortcut, and then the Model Line has the LI shortcut. So let's start off with the model lines. So when it comes to these model lines, they are, well, as the name would suggest, they're model elements. That means that they are going to appear pretty much everywhere. So if you create a model line, so when you click on the model line, you just get the basic draw tools as you get for anything else. And when you place a model line, and let's place one here in the middle. So this is now in the middle of our floor plan view. But if I open up the 3D view, you can see that line over there. So we have this line and it's visible in the 3D view as well. If I open up one of the elevations, you can see there's the line there. So it's going to be visible in all views. So that's the model line. However, if I were to go back into level 1 and then go to my Annotate tab and place a detail line. So again, just a detail line here, and I'm just going to place it next to this one. There we go. Hit the escape key a couple of times. When I go to the 3D view, the detail line is not going to be there. Same thing goes for the south elevation. So it's only going to appear in the view where you have drawn that. So it's one of those view specific elements or annotation elements inside of Revit. Now we're going to concentrate first on the detail lines. On the model lines. So for the model lines, you can place them like this, and you can specify the work plane where you're working. But what really makes these useful is that you can actually place them on other model elements. So for example, if I were to have a wall here, and if I just placed a curtain wall, let's go with a regular, okay, something like that. So if I had this wall here, I can go to the 3D view, and then I can come in here, I can go to model line, and then I can place a model line here on this wall. So I can go to placement plane, go to pick, and then I can pick a plane, click OK, and I can pick this face of the wall, and now I can start drawing lines on this wall. So if you want to have some lines that should follow your wall, you can do that with model lines, and now they're basically something that's going to strap to the face of that wall. And if you open up the south elevation, as you can see, those lines are going to be there. So if you want to add some additional line work to your model elements, such as walls, for example, you can do that by using model lines. They obviously have some thickness here. If we zoom in, there we go. So that's what really makes these model lines useful. Now you can actually turn your model lines into regular lines. So if you want, or in detail lines. So if you select a line like this, here you'll see it says convert lines. However, in this case, it's grayed out. Well, that's because you can only do this in certain places. So you cannot do this in a 3D view. If you go to the south elevation, what you'll see here, now I can select, let's select these two. So you can select these two lines and say convert lines. So it's just going to convert these into detail lines. So now when I select these should be detail lines, and then these should be model lines. So let's go back to the 3D view. There we go. So in the 3D view, those are missing because now they're view specific and they're only going to appear in this particular view over here. So that's basically how you can convert your model lines into regular detail lines. However, you can also convert your detail lines into model lines. So if I go back here, so this, as you remember, this is now a detail line. I cannot convert this, but if I go into level one and create a detail line here, so let's create just one simple detail line, just like that. I can select this detail line and then I can say convert lines, and it is going to convert it into a model line. So now this is going to appear in the 3D view. Even though I have drawn it as a detail line, I can convert it into a model line. But that only works in floor plan views, so it's not going to work in elevations or sections. So just something to keep in mind when it comes to these, when it comes to converting model lines or detail lines into model lines. Okay, now let's talk about copying your detail lines from view to view. So I'm just going to delete this model line here, and then let's go into our level one and let's place an additional detail line next to it. So just like this. So this is a detail line. It's not going to appear in the 3D view. It's only visible in this floor plan view. How about, let's say that we want to copy this from level one into the site plan. So we want to see that line both in level one and the site plan, but I don't want to see it anywhere else. So I don't want to convert this into a model line. I want to keep it as a detail line, but I also want it to appear in the site plan. Well, luckily, we do have the option to basically copy these from view to view. So you can copy your detail elements just by going here to copy to clipboard, going to paste, and then you can align that to selected views. So you can basically paste it in any aligned view. Aligned view basically means if you have a floor plan, well, then you can place it in another floor plan that's above or below. You cannot copy and paste it into a section. So from a floor plan to a section, that wouldn't work, or from a floor plan to an elevation, that doesn't work. But as long as those views are parallel, like your plan views here, well, then it will work. So if I select the site plan here and click OK, now if I go to my site plan, you will see that this has been copied into the site plan. So if you have a need to copy your detail lines from one plan view to another, you can do that by going here to the copy and then paste, and just use the aligned to selected views option. Okay, finally, let's talk about customizing these lines. Obviously, when I have drawn them, we have the green one and the black one, so we don't really have much customization there. So let's talk about customizing them. So when you select any of these lines, here you'll see that we have a line style panel, and if I expand that, you will see that here we have some options for line styles. So if I switch this from your regular lines, which are green for some reason, if I switch that to wide lines, it will be a wide black line. If I switch that to hidden, it's going to be hidden, so that means dashed. And then if I switch to one of the others, so for example, demolished, so these are all kind of subcategories that work with other elements, but here we have an option for medium lines, so that's that. And then what else do we have? We have the thin lines, so that's just thinner. And then here, just because of this template that I'm using, my architecture design template, here you see I have an orange dashed line, which I like to use. I have orange T2, so that means that the thickness is set to 2, and an orange T5, which means the thickness is set to 5. So I've added these orange lines here as well. So you can use any one of these for your model lines, and you can change the line style. Now you can do that after the line has been placed, but also before. If I just go here to model line, You'll see here, next to our draw tools, we have our line styles. Dialog, so I can pick out any line that I want to use here, and then I can, well, I can obviously use that particular line style. The same thing goes for detail lines. So here in the level one floor plan, I can go to annotate, I can go to detail line, and then here you'll see that we have pretty much those same options for the detail lines. And then also if you select your detail lines, you will have the same options to pick out which one of these line styles you want to use. And then also, if you select it, you'll see that it also appears here in the properties panel. So we have that option as well. It's basically the same menu. You can get it here or here. It's really up to you. Okay, that's nice, but how do we actually set up these options that are available here? We do have a limited dialog or a limited set of lines, but what if I want to create a very, very wide blue line? How do I do that? Well, we obviously don't have that option over here. So what we can do is we can go to the Manage tab, and then on the Manage tab, hidden behind the Additional Settings dialog, we have the line styles dialog. So the line styles dialog looks like this, and if I expand this, what you'll see here is we have all of the lines that are available there. So some of these are kind of system line styles, like the sketch or the room separation, overhead, hidden lines, fabric, and so on. And then below here we have kind of our sketching lines, the wide lines, the thin lines, the lines, medium lines, hidden lines, dashed lines, and these that are part of my template. Now you can choose either one of these, and then here you can set up their line weight. You can go anywhere from 1 to 16. This one is set to 5. You can set up the color here, so you can pick out any color that you would like, and then here you have the line pattern. So which pattern would you like to use? So you have all of those options as well. You can even set up the pattern, but that's a little bit more advanced. I talk about that in that course. So if you want to check that out, feel free to find it there. And then you can modify one of these existing lines. However, I wouldn't recommend that. What I would recommend is creating a new line style. So you just go here to modify subcategories. What you'll see here is that for some of these, we can actually modify them. So for example, these orange ones that I have created as part of my template, you can actually delete those or rename them. However, if you go to one of the other ones, the system ones, you don't have the option to delete them or to rename them. Now we can also create new lines. So if I go here to new, I can create a name. So let's call this one the new test line style. Okay. Subcategory of lines, obviously, click OK. And here it is. So now I can, as I said, let's say I want to have a really wide, so let's go with 10, blue, so let's go with blue line, and then I can say, okay, I don't want it to be solid, I want it to be dash dot, for example, and then I can say apply. Okay, now what this does is now if I select this line here and expand the menu, now we have, let's see, that new test line style. And if I select that one, as you can see, it's a really wide blue dash dot line that we have created. And then obviously you can go back and you can modify it here. So if you want to make some changes, let's say that was a bit too wide. Let's say I want to go from 10 to, I don't know, like 6. Hit apply. As you can see, now it's a lot thinner. It's still a wide line, but not as wide. So there you go. That's how you can customize your lines inside of Revit. So I hope you have learned something new. I hope you now know how to differentiate the detail lines from your model lines, how to customize the lines, and just what are some of the different behaviors that they have. If you would like to get some of my Revit project files, well, actually all of my Revit project files, those are available on my Patreon page, and I'm going to be leaving a link to it just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. I have over 400 models there so far, and I'm adding more each week with each of these videos. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.